Chevrolet and your Super Chevy dealers proudly present Paradise, Louisiana with Gary Risponi, Joe Macaluso, and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana, powered by Chevrolet, would also like to thank these sponsors. Aerial Access Equipment, the leader in aerial work platforms. Borden, if it's Borden, it's got to be good. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana. The Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores. We have more than you expect. Farm Bureau Insurance. Louisiana Fish Fry. Louisiana Land Bank. Mastercraft Tires. Area Wholesale Tires, with tire programs for tire dealers.
Hi, and welcome to this week's Hurricane Edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I'm Joe Macaluso.
I'm Don Dubuque. Hope we don't get too much damage.
I'm Gary Risponi. You know, it's bearing down on us, so we'll find out for sure. When y'all watching this, we don't know whether we'll be back next week or we get blown down. We get blown up north.
Well, we hope we don't get blown up north. We hope the any damage from Isaac is minimal at best. But I think what we're looking at now is, after talking to State Waterfowl Study Leader Larry Reynolds over the weekend, anytime we get a hurricane now, it's really gonna hurt, because we had a lot of good growth, especially after Gustav and after we came through Katrina. Everything looked like it was going to be in great shape coming for the duck season. We know that teal season starts in a couple of weeks, and we're just going to have to wait and see. But it looks like a 6-foot tidal surge coming out of this this storm, you know, might do a lot of damage.
Well, you know, that'll just put us on equal footing with the guys north of us. They didn't get any crops in. The drought hurt them real bad. So, hey, we'll just kind of I'll be happy to go equal with them. You know, we don't have as much feed as we could have had, but we still can get a good.
We had some of the farmers and even a couple of biologists, wildlife fishers, were at the duck festival this past weekend, and they were talking about the same thing. They don't think it's going to hurt the teal as much, because teal mm-hmm. not quite got in. But you remember, Joe, we were right ahead of a hurricane one time, and you and I were killing teal, waiting for Rita
exactly
to come in. And all that rain has scared them, and it kept them there a while. All that water kept them there a little while longer. But the big duck is a different story, and I know what you're saying now. It's especially down on the coast right now. They got all that good vegetation, and if that salt water burns, it'd be bad.
Well,
that's going to hurt is the freshwater fishing in the Chaffinchoy Spillway and all the way down those rivers. Them rivers low, there's going to be a lot of salt water intrusion. I think it's going to hurt bad. So
we'll see, because one of the things we always worry about is low dissolved oxygen
sure.
after these storms and the fish kills. We've seen too many of them. We're in the 20th, anniversary of Hurricane Andrew, and everybody remembers what that did throughout the Florida parishes, throughout Lake Verret, and especially in the Atchafalaya Basin. But we won't know. Maybe this time next week we will. I know you made a trip to the Pearl River, and that's usually one of the areas that,
yeah.
because of the depth of water, that usually doesn't see a lot of fish kills after storms.
Right. Well, hopefully that's will be the case on this time. But we did catch some saltwater fish up there, pretty good ways up, too. And when you think of Pearl River, you usually think of fishing bass or brim or something like that. But there's some redfish, there's some flounder, and some trout right now.
Well, you're not going to believe it. A guy called me last week, Mike Pennington, lives in Livonia, and he said he caught a sheepshead 5 miles south of the bridge in the Atchafalaya River, south of 190.
Wow.
So, you know, if we're seeing some strange things like that, just think what it's going to be like after the storm. You made a trip to Gaydon, the state duck and goose calling contest.
All right. And we got some of the dog trials and the state goose and duck calling championships. And what's amazing thing is some young people taking over. I don't know if they knocked them out. We had one old-timer come back. But Jason Campbell, he came back mm-hmm. and he placed. He didn't win. But the young people that were getting older, I think the older guys that trained these are standing mm-hmm. aside and say, all right, guys, let's go. See if y'all can do a lot better on the world championships.
Well, we're going to go take a visit with Gerald Horse, whose new book, Trout Masters mm-hmm. 2, is out. Terrific read. I know you and I have had a chance to look through it. We're going to talk to Gerald later in the show. We're going to have a little news segment. made a trip to the first ever antique duck decoy show, waterfowl show, at the Bluebonnet Swamp Nature Center last Saturday. Terrific event. We're going to talk about the dove season, and naturally we'll tell a little bit about the weather. Made a visit to Women in the Wild last week at Wadeel Wildlife Refuge Education Center. That was terrific. And then we're going to, believe it or not, we might even have a fish report for later, which well, might mean
you believe away. This? I made a little trip to Chaffalot Spillway on the south end. That's the lower part of Sawland, and by April with Jody Russo. Caught a bunch of sycophants, seen a bunch of people catching sycophants in that area.
Well, we'll be right back, right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
It all adds up to a giant Silverado clearance event at your Super Chevy dealers. Hurry, trade in your old truck and get a brand new 2012 Silverado. Chevy Confidence priced at just $19,715. $19,715 by Silverado. Plus, get an industry-leading 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty at your Super Chevy dealers.
Mr. Gay, we're going to miss the morning bite. If you want food and snacks, we better hurry up.
I tell you what, you pump the gas, I get the food.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
Aerial Access Equipment has been serving Louisiana, the Mississippi Gulf Coast, and Southeast Texas since 1998. Our trained sales staff has the expertise necessary to ensure our customers get the right piece of equipment for the job at competitive rental rates. Need help with choosing the right machine for the job? We'll come to your job site and recommend the right machine to meet your needs. Remember, quality. Reliability, safety. Aerial Access Equipment, your aerial work platform and forklift specialist.
Hi, welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. There's a river on the east side of the state. In fact, it's the easternmost river in the state of Louisiana, the Pearl. Terrific opportunity there. I don't know that there's another river in our state that can support, except maybe the Mississippi, that can support as many species in such a diverse habitat as the Mississippi is. And then you go on the east side in the Pearl River too. But the diversity is there.
It's incredible. I mean, you can catch everything from freshwater catfish, brim, goggle-eye, bass, sackalay up on the northern end, and at times down in the lower end. Of course, got a great bass fishery there too. But right now, you kind of got that salt water moving up from the Wrigley's area. We'll find out after this storm comes through if how severely, if at all, it'll be affected. But we had a pretty good trip up there. Mike Gallo was telling me, look, we got some trout located in the Pearl. They're not big fish by any means. They're not the mules, but they've got a good many of them in there. There's also some reds mixed in there and picked up some flounder.
Wow.
It's full of bait. We saw lots of pogies, a few shrimp jumping around. We went up in there with live bait, fished it on the bottom with his drop shot, fished him with a popping cork, had Iron Mike along there. Mm-hmm. Mike had a tough day that day, but he managed to pull
through.
Change
over, like now the water floor. Where's the combination trips? I know you've been over there in the Pearl where you catch bass, and just like you do down in Venice, you get a certain water. You catch bass, sycophant, and then you go and catch redfish and speckled trout. What area is it? Does it move that area, move up and down?
We've heard reports of catching speckled trout even on the north side of I-10. They'll get up that far. And anytime you get up that far, you're likely to catch a mixed combination. But mostly that occurs down in that marsh area. The pure river that's running through the Piney Woods or the Cypress Tupelo Swamp, that's going to be more of a freshwater species there. And occasionally you'll get fish up there, particularly redfish. But as Mike Gallo will tell you right now, you know, with the fish kind of got the spawn out of the way, and they're starting to move up in there. They're not necessarily as critical for them to have high salinity, so it's a little bit lower salinity. But there's some good action in there, and Captain Mike Gallo's got some tips talking about fishing at Pearl River, which is a protected area. So if you can't get out to where you'd like to, small boat or whatever, weather conditions, don't forget about the Pearl, not just for freshwater, but saltwater too. Okay. Now, when you think about fishing the Pearl River, you're probably thinking bass and maybe brim. But when conditions are like they are now, you got to say, move over, bass, for speckled trout.
The river's very low right now, and there's a lot of salt water backing up into the river. There's always a lot of bait in the river area in that transformation where it's not salt and it's not fresh, the marshy area. A lot of these fish that we're catching, I believe, were simply not old enough to spawn 2 months ago, but now they've grown long enough to be legal. Because a lot of our fish are right at that 12, 12 and a half inch mark. You did catch some nice ones that I'm sure are old enough to spawn. The other day when we caught some, no eggs in them. I think out of the 15 fish I cleaned, one fish had eggs in it. So that kind of verifies that I think these fish were not old enough to spawn earlier in the year, and now they've simply grown long enough to be legal to keep.
No, it's a trout. All right, these are not going to be your big mule trout by any means, but they're going to be great for the frying pan.
It does seem this year we're seeing the fish in the Pearl River a little earlier than normal. I can't figure out whether it was Tropical Storm Bonnie earlier in the year that pushed in a lot of salt water, or is it the Great Wall in Chalmette and the Seabrook being closed having something to do with a different hydrology. Maybe more salt water is coming around in Biloxi Marsh, and this is going to be the first place that water is going to hit on its way into Lake Pontchartrain. Ooh, look at that. He was that close to throwing the hook. Well, even today we caught a variety of fish. Yesterday we caught, we had black drum, redfish, a few flounder, speckled trout. We had one white trout. We haven't caught a bass yet, and that may be an indication of the really salty water pushing those bass further up north. Normally the Pearl River is very good and very consistent in October and throughout the winter. Once those fish stop spawning, they're no longer concerned with being in very salty water. So they'll go in the Pearl River as far up as Highway 90, and I've heard as far up as I-10. I've caught them as far up as Highway 90 in the past. And it's great because you can get out of the wind, protected waters, small boats can get to it, larger boats can get to it. It provides a lot of opportunity. That was right at you, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Okay. Might be a catfish too. Oh, it's a little drum. Got him looking at it. Well, just like today, we started out fishing on the bottom in some of the deeper holes, and we go through a process of elimination. We worked our way to some shallower areas, hard bottom, with grassy shorelines, and that's where we caught the majority of our fish, under a popping cork with live shrimp, as well as we caught some on plastics.
Not a speckled sea monster. That's a spotted sea munchkin.
That's a nice trout too.
All right, there's a nice speckled trout for back here in the marsh. Remember, there's two reasons why these fish are back up this far. Number one, the fall transition that takes place every year is already underway. And number two, high salinities brings a bait, and that brings a trout.
Paradise, Louisiana.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
Aerial Access Equipment has been serving Louisiana, the Mississippi Gulf Coast, and Southeast Texas since 1998. Our trained sales staff has the expertise necessary to ensure our customers get the right piece of equipment for the job at competitive rental rates. Need help with choosing the right machine for the job? We'll come to your job site and recommend the right machine to meet your needs. Remember, quality, reliability, safety. Aerial Access Equipment, your aerial work platform and forklift specialist.
Of all the tools in your house, this could easily be the most dangerous, but it doesn't have to be. At Dimco, we can't stress this enough. Just keep it and you far away from power lines.
Dimco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Well, welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. And Gerald Horst, you hit another home run here, man. I mean, we're gonna have to put you in the Hall of Fame somewhere. Trout Masters, I think a lot of people enjoyed that book when they first came out. Now we have Trout Masters 2, and, how come there's not a big... I know you're a very literal sort of guy. How come there wasn't it the numeral 2?
Well, it's because they aren't the 14 second-best fishermen.
Okay.
You know, the first book was a runaway bestseller, as you know.
Yeah.
And everybody said, I want another book. We want another book. And so I was left with, what do I do? Go to the... Because we had 14 people in the first book. Do I go to the 14 second-best people? And I didn't want to do that. And so these are Trout Masters, too, but these are all charter guides. First book was primarily non-guides. Mm-hmm. So whole different category of folks.
I'm thinking here that there are a lot of familiar names in here. And
yes,
I know
there
Don
are.
And I, and you have fished with every one of them. That's for sure, because that's how you did the book. But when you look at it, I think that the most impressive part about this book is the tips and the information come from guys who have spent a lifetime on the water. Not that Trout Masters didn't do that, because it did, but these guys seem to have a little bit better feel for overall trout catching.
Well, they're professionals, and that's the subtitle says it. It's how the pros do it. I mean, they're professionals. That's nothing to take away from the people in the first book that dedicated their life to chasing fish, but chasing trout, trophy specs.
Would you say that the original Trout Masters was written from the standpoint of a group of people whose quest was for that big trophy trout, and the other is for maybe quantity, and people who are fishing for regularity, consistency in catching, but not necessarily a big fish?
I think this one straddles both. If you'll notice, one of the major differences we've done is we put really detailed maps in this book.
Right, I noticed that.
And, you know, the maps for fishing great big fish, a map doesn't do you much good, because those great big fish are in tiny areas. But this does lay out a year-round blueprint for fishing an area with the maps. Now, they don't ignore big fish. Everyone in there has credentials in big fish.
Sure.
And we talk about it a lot, but it goes beyond that. And of course, if you'll notice, the book is half again thicker than the other book, because we had to cover so much more ground.
But it also has a little profile of each fisherman, a little
background
question. That really makes a story more than a how-to, where-to.
When I first did the first Trout Masters, I really took a risk, because, you know, most of us outdoor writers, we write how-to, where-to, right, Joe?
Right.
And, you know, to talk about the people and develop them as characters, you know, I said, are sportsmen really going to be interested in how these people got to be the great athletes? Because that's what they are.
Mm-hmm.
How they got to be the great athletes they are. Well, it was a big hit. So we followed in that format here. But as you pointed out, it's full of tips, and there's also a great calendar of fishing with each person produces it. There's one other thing that we did try to do with this book that wasn't in this book. We took the best people we could find regardless of area.
Mm-hmm.
Now, some areas have a lot bigger specs than other areas.
Mm-hmm.
And it meant that some places, really great fishing got left out in this book.
Right.
St.
Here.
Bernard
sure.
Parish,
mm-hmm.
Terrebonne
mm-hmm.
Parish,
mm-hmm.
not here.
Right.
We have two chapters on Terrebonne, two chapters on St. Bernard. So what we have attempted to do, we've recognized the fact that What's a big fish in Terrebonne is not the same as a big fish in Calcasieu Lake. Mm-hmm. A big fish in Terrebonne is 5 pounds.
Right.
It's just as much of an achievement to catch a 5 pounder there as it is an 8 pounder in Calcasieu.
Well, the one thing I did notice is there, if you talk about, if you think you had a cast of characters in Troutman, this thing's loaded with characters. And I mean, you know, like characters like your mama told you about, like, watch that, he's a character, okay? It's very good. And I like the fact that Vermilion Bay is covered in it.
You know where else? That's Sabine, a good, yes, and Sabine Lake.
Right.
That gets very little press in Louisiana.
Right.
It's really a gem that our anglers don't know about. It's essentially another version that's a lot less fished.
Well, thank you for opening it up.
Thank you.
You want to catch it, Shags, I know, in Metairie. There's several places.
Yeah.
Puglia's, Lakeside Newsstand's got it.
And he'll be coming to a show near you.
Oh, yeah. Every time you turn around, you see his great shock of gray hair there somewhere.
Supporting with a lot of good photos,
professional, superior tackle in Baton Rouge. Hutch's, I know, is a great place.
Hutch's
in Gonzales. Yeah. Bridgeside Marina's got it. Acadia Outdoors in New Iberia. And Lake Charles Tackle.
Katie Ann Outfitters. I miswrote it, so sorry about that.
It's all right. It's all there.
Well, you read what I wrote. So.
Well, anyway, here it is. Trout Masters 2, Gerald Horst, thank you. You did another great job, man.
Yeah. And all of the locations that we have listed have autographed copies.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Your autograph? We'll be right back from Paradise, Louisiana. Don't touch that remote.
These engines run for thousands of hours to prove. With 20% more cleaning agents than before, Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline.
Oh, the gasoline protects your engine better!
Awkward.
Try new Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines.
No other gasoline protects your engine better.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading hunting or fishing.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with 4 electrolytes lost in sweat.
When did insurance companies start emailing handshakes? Why is a billboard the only place you see your agent's face? Who decided you can't have good rates and good coverage? If you're questioning your insurance options, get real answers from a real person with a Farm Bureau confidential insurance review. It's simple, quick, and tailored just for you. Call today. Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service. Real people.
Back to Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. Why don't you tell me, why is it every time when we mention the Duck and Goose Calling Contest and the Gate on Duck Festival that we mention hurricanes right in the same sentence?
Seems to be held during that prime time.
But anyway, the end of August, that last weekend in August, always time to get the gate on. If you love waterfowl hunting, this is the place to be because it gets you excited about it. And I know you made a trip down there. Dog trials, big festival, dances, beauty contests.
And it was coming up by a storm, you know, the first day there. Friday evening, staying all the way down there. They cut the dog trials a little bit short that morning, and then they had to come back and do it. Sun was shining for the parade, just like last time. It don't rain on that parade, and then it did it, but the parade was nice. You know, the beauty pageant, everything is good. The bands, the most outstanding. Mm-hmm. When there's a hunting and fishing show, we're going to talk about hunting and fishing.
They must have been good.
Talk about the food. Talk about the food, Joe. You know their food. They feed me well. You know, I go to Cormier's, too. That little kitchen, little Cajun kitchen. Yeah, I eat good there, too. But let me tell you, watch those dogs. You know, your boy, Mr. Evans, Mark Evans.
Uh-huh.
And he was down there with all them dogs. But they come from all over because these dog trainers in there. Kid Vendrina, good friend of mine in the last 5 or 6 years with Brian Briggs and them, his dog won it. I said, Dawn is Dawn's best. As Kid Vendrina, his dog won the to finish division. The season division was Dixie Shatter, oh, by Rotterdam. Entremont, yeah. Entremont, they say it differently. Odemont. Yeah. Some people say Odemont. And that dog was was trained by Odemont, but it was Bo Robertson, his dog. And then the starter, we had some great starter dogs. I saw Mr. Lloyd Carville there, one of the oldest trainers around. He's still saying, though, I was tickled. That's Jody's big friend. But Candy won, Dale Johnson. And the dog was owned by Nick Sylvester. So we got a shot at them dogs. And I'm telling you what, they're real good. Young ladies training their dogs again, still back there. We had some good retrieves that we saw dogs do it. And the weather was terrible. The mosquitoes were bad, but the dogs were
tremendous. Well, how about Skeetcha? I know they do a lot of activities. The Skeetcha, usually there's a woman who wins Skeetcha.
Yeah, somewhere. I tell you what, there's a lot of women shooting, and we got a few shots of that, and we got them. You know, all I can tell you is, you know, it's a great deal, and we'll come back later. And the main thing we was there for was the Duck and Goose Calling Championships, and we're going to introduce you to the state champions in a few minutes.
When we come back, we're going right back to Gaydon for the state Duck and Goose Calling Championships. Congratulations to those guys. You really worked hard.
Bryce Smith, and I'm from Gaydon, Louisiana.
My name is Chelsea Bertrand, and I'm from Gaydon, Louisiana.
Dog's name is Indy. We're from Lake Charles.
Hey, this is Hammer. My name's Mark Briley, and I live in Grand Prairie. Yep. Good.
Mary Roy, and I'm from Gaydon, Louisiana.
So, Stanley Cormier, from Park at Island, Louisiana. My dog is HRCH, Master Hunter, one grand pass, Grizz.
Dave Fullerton, I'm from Gaydon.
What's that dog name?
This is Deuce. Deuce.
You know, whether it's fishing or hunting or any other outdoor sport, there's always one tool I can count on, my Chevy truck. Not only is my Chevy Silverado a rugged hauling machine on the outside, but also quiet and comfortable on the inside.
Yeah, Joe, just like my new Suburban. Got all the towing I need, plus storage and room for me and my buddies.
Chevy Trucks, the official truck of Louisiana Outdoors.
Go see them up close. It's the Super Chevy dealers today.
You are watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Oh, that's the way I like it.
Nothing's better than broiled seafood. Spiced just right. And Louisiana Fish Fry Products makes it easy to boil right every time.
Can't get enough.
Grab a bag. There's nothing to mix. Just pour and boil.
Aw, now you're cooking.
Crawfish, crab, or shrimp. With Louisiana Fish Fry Products, you got boiling down easy.
That's the way I like it. Oh.
If phrases like this mean something to you, maybe you should come work for us. If you identify more with phrases like these, then maybe you should put us to work for you. The Mastercraft LSR Touring.
Welcome to the 2012 State Goose and Duck Calling Championship, the Junior Duck Calling Championship. Mr. Rusty Grove from Marrero, Louisiana.
Yes, sir.
Rusty, you're the talk of the town today. Everybody I talked to, Mr. Brian Briggs, everybody that know you, were talking about how well you called today. They heard you just practicing.
Yes,
you
sir.
Took it all today. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Where you go to school, Rusty?
Jesuit High School.
Jesuit High School.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, where you learn to blow a duck call? Who's your biggest teacher?
A friend in Arkansas. His name's Dale Bartlett. He inspired me, and then from the rest, I just took it myself and taught myself how to blow a duck call.
Well, you're getting ready to go to Arkansas right now and blow in the world championships?
Yes, sir.
Are we ready?
I'm ready. I'm very, very excited.
Practice and working hard, you know. This year I really wanted to, you know, come and do my best, you know, say, make the judges think, well, who is that on stage, you know, who is that blowing that good, you know. So trying to do my best this year, and hopefully I'll place in world, you know, just working as hard as I can.
Well, I've been watching you since you were 7 years. From how old are you right now?
I'm 16.
16, you know, but 72 was real little.
Yeah.
Now you're real big.
Mm-hmm. I drove here today. So.
Go to Arkansas and show them how to do it.
Yeah, I will.
Congratulations to you and your dad and the rest of your family.
Thank you.
Oh, it's something pretty special just to qualify. I'd qualified last year. This will be my second year. Hopefully I have a little better showing over there, but it sure is special to go over there. As far as blowing a duck call, I'd probably say my biggest teacher is probably Mr. Butch Richenbeck at R&T Calls. He helps me out a lot. Also, I have a good buddy, Nathan Wright, helps me out with it as well.
Yeah, well, you did a great job. Congratulations. What do you think it's going to take in the World Championships right now? What are you going to do a little different than you did before?
Be better, be smoother, and be clean. Hopefully get the nerves out of the way, too.
Well, you got it out here today. You were impressive.
That's it.
Congratulations. Good luck. 2012 Louisiana State Duck Calling Championship. Champion Nick Potan. The Louisiana State Champions and Snow Geese call. Is it Matthew Oquant? Matthew, I wasn't here last year. I know you was here last year, but you blew them away today. I'm watching you. I told somebody, I said, where this kid been? I haven't seen him. And you, tell me where you from.
Del City, Louisiana.
Now, you must have some pretty good teachers. If you've only been blowing a year, because, you know, you state champion now. I've got a big title. Who you attribute teaching you?
Brian Harris, Bill Daniels, and James Myers.
Well, you have some big names right there. You just named some guys that are on the winning circle all the time, and here's one right here, Mr. Brian Harris. Brian, you're back doing it again. You know, what else can I say? You're always up in the money. So what a tremendous job you did.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Now, what do you attribute coming back and doing every year, every year? You know, you and Jason Campbell and some of these other guys, how'd you get Billy Daniels to stay out of it?
He won so many, they had to kick him out finally.
That's the way he did
it? No.
Yeah. You told me a story, and really good. You know, one of our big sponsors, and they help sponsors this, is Louisiana Fish Fry. Tell me the story you told me a while ago.
I brought one of my gift packs that I won a couple of years ago to Russia when we went spec hunting in Russia. And so now Louisiana Fish Fry is in Russia.
How do you hunt speckled bears in Russia? It's the same thing. We got cornfields, you got rice fields. What you got?
It's pretty much the same. They, the same bird.
About to hit the road. Here we are, Gaydon, Louisiana, and State Goose and Duck Calling Championships. A familiar face, Mr. Austin Hebert. Austin, I don't know, from Youngville, I've been watching you since you go. I don't know how long you're going to keep on doing this. And we got William Fassabend. I said it right?
Yes, sir.
All right, 17 years old, first try, the senior division, speckled bellies. Speckled bellies to me is my favorite. It's one of the hardest things to master. All the masters that are back cheering y'all on, you know, who's your teacher?
My dad and Mr. Jason Campbell and Mr. Kelly Haydell mostly. You know, my dad's been one of the biggest supports other than Mr. Kelly and Mr. Jason. You know, he's taught me, hey, you know, do this, do that, you know, you got to sound more like a goose.
You know, then I got you here. You know, your dad, they promote shooting sports with the 4-H. You had your friend winning nationals in shooting sports, and so you're going to be branching off to that. Then next year, you're going to be in the senior division. All your mentors will be there. You're going to have to go there and beat them. You think you can handle it?
I'll give them a run for their money. I think they're going to have to tighten down because I'm coming all full force.
Yeah, that's a good thing. Yeah. And what about the shooting sports?
That too. They're going to they're going to have to shoot straight because I'm going to be shooting straight.
Well, the rest of this year, I'm going to get your daddy over here. We're going to talk about that because that's getting real popular in the state. You come over, y'all change places. I want to talk to this guy here. It's a familiar face. I tell you what, I saw you get the best prize around. I saw your girlfriend grab and give you a big hug while ago. Boy, I tell you what, that's enough to make any guy excited, especially pretty like that.
Absolutely.
Tell me where you hunt and where you from.
Hunt all over, mostly south of Welsh and Hayes area.
Yeah. Tell me who's your mentors and who's your teachers.
People that have taught me the most are James Myers, Bill Daniels, Brian Harris, and Mike Miller.
Well, you got you named about four or five state champions right off the bat.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And how long you been blowing?
My whole life.
Your whole life?
Yes, sir.
Tell you what, you did a great job today. Just to think of 17-year-old, this is your state champion, Speckle Belly Carl. Miriam, say that name again.
Fastabend.
Here they are, state champions. You stay tuned. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. This is Louisiana, Paradise, Louisiana. Gate on, one of my favorite places to visit, one of my favorite places to hunt.
About my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
The 2012 Louisiana Saltwater Series is the state's premier saltwater tournament. Hosted by the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries, this is a catch, tag, and release tournament. There are six qualifying events held across the state's coast, plus a championship. Entry fee is $200 for each two-man team, plus there's a youth division of two anglers under 16 per team. This is a 100% payout plus prize tournament. For details and to register, visit lasaltwaterseries.com.
The way I like it.
Nothing's better than boiled seafood. Spiced just right. And Louisiana Fish Fry Products makes it easy to boil right every time.
Can't get enough.
Grab a bag. There's nothing to mix. Just pour and boil.
Aw, now you're cooking.
Crawfish, crab, or shrimp. With Louisiana Fish Fry Products, you got boiling down easy.
That's the way.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. I had a chance while you were looking at dogs and listening to duck calls. I was going back to, I think, what has become the true collectible in Louisiana, and it's duck decoys and old duck decoys. And truly an experience to go to the Blue Bonnet Swamp Nature Center. Miss Jean Frank was there. Because her husband was honored, and you know Charles. Sure. Why don't you tell us about Charles Frank?
Charles Frank, world traveler, fisherman, outdoor writer, wrote books, and just a great all-around guy, and quite a collector, too, mm-hmm. a photographer, and he had an extensive collection. I visited his place over there in New Orleans once, and I was amazed at what he had in there, and some of this has been donated now.
Right, some of it's donated. It's in a special wing that was dedicated to Charles Frank's memory at the Blue Bonnet Swamp Nature Center. It's off North Oak Hills Parkway, off Blue Bonnet Boulevard in Baton Rouge. There is a wing in there now that has, it looks like, about as many as 80 of his decoys. There are films in there that go on. It's a wonderful little area. If you want to know about antique decoys, the history of using them in waterfowl hunting in Louisiana, I think it's going to be the biggest repository of that kind of artwork and that kind of collectibles in the state. It's a wonderful opportunity. But what it did was the dedication brought 37 collectors to the Bluebonnet Swamp Nature Center. There were old boats there, one Cypress Pirogue that had floated up in one of the storms that they figured was more than 100 years old. But a lot of old decoys. Saw a decoy, a Canada Goose decoy that's made out of canvas. And they figure it might be 80 to 90 years old. There were other decoys there, very primitive, some state of the art. There were just so many of them there.
How many security guards they had there?
You know what? I didn't see any, but I imagine you couldn't have made it out of the door, you know, with one on your arm. But it was beautiful.
There were even a few of your duck carvers were at the gate on Duck Festival. They had their little booths, and they were teaching people how to carve. You know, some of the guys down in Golden Meadow cut off, you know, they come all the way up every year, and Mr. Roger was showing them doing that. And Joe, I want to talk about news, and I'm going to do this next week, one at a time. They did have a cook-off, by the way, and a cook-off sponsored by the Louisiana Fish Fry and them, and that Sunday cook-off, got some unique dishes. I'm going to bring you that next week, though. I just wanted to tell you, we've got you on a new
from
segment.
The Duck Festival?
The Duck Festival, the cook-off was, believe me, a surprise.
Well, we did have a chance, to stop for the next in a succession of combination of the alliance between Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries and Cabela's. Women in the Wild was last Saturday. If you get a chance, any of the women in the state, I know there's other, Becoming Outdoors Woman is one of the big programs, but this is a one-day big shooting event, teach you how to track animals, teach you what to look for. There were shooting segments in there, archery. To me, it looked like 32 women just had an enjoyable day.
Blind safety, they do blind safety, how to climb with climbing stands. Joe, I went last year, I totally enjoyed it. I'm sorry to have to miss it this year, but like you said, they really concentrate. Them 32 people get hands-on.
Right.
Man, they get shotgun shooting and rifle shooting. Mm-hmm. I
tell you what, you don't want to be downrange with any of those women, okay? Because the first time they picked up a .22 rifle, I didn't see many that were outside of that circle at 25 meters, okay?
There were
a lot of good shots.
Shot that board out pretty good, too.
It was a great opportunity to go out there and see it. Their next opportunity is September the 8th at Cabela's. They're doing a kayaking seminar, day long. Go in there, learn about the kayaks, and get on the pond right on site and learn how to
be
paddle.
Be ready for Ride the Bull next year.
That's right. Oh, okay, let's talk about dove season. It starts Saturday. There was a correction now. If you go pick up the State Wildlife and Fisheries regulations booklet for the hunting season, it'll tell you that the hunting hours for September the 3rd is noon to sunset. That's incorrect. The hunting hours for opening day, September 1st, in both the north and south zones is noon to sunset. So that's only on Saturday, September the 1st. All the other days, how long did we push for that? Maybe 20 years, yeah. And then they find now, if I think for the fourth year, we hunt all the other days, go half hour before sunrise to sunset. The first splits open up next Saturday. Let's hope the weather doesn't get
to
us.
That's why they call them morning doves.
There are a lot of doves.
Okay.
Is that why they call them morning doves? So you shoot them in the morning?
I'm gonna pop him in the head. What you think? Anyway, look, there's some special regulations. I would invite you to go to the Department of Wildlife and Fisheries, find out about white-winged doves, find out about the Eurasian collar doves, the ringed turtle doves. Just go find out about that because there's special regulations for that. And the weather, I guess, cross your fingers and let's hope we don't see too much of a residual from Mr. Isaac coming in. What you think?
The dove hunting might be better in North Louisiana, but then again, it may not. We'll see.
We'll be right back, right here from Paradise, Louisiana.
It all adds up to a giant Silverado clearance event at your Super Chevy dealers. Hurry, trade in your old truck and get a brand new 2012 Silverado. Chevy Confidence priced at just $19,715. $19,715 by Silverado. Plus, get an industry-leading 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty at your Super Chevy dealers.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with four electrolytes lost in sweat.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
The 2012 CCA Louisiana Star Fishing Tournament is here. 101 days to fish and over $500,000 in prizes in over 25 divisions, including the return of Red Snapper and Sheephead divisions, offshore, inshore, kayak, fly fishing, ladies only, and Mississippi Trout division. The Star has something for everyone, and those 50 specially tagged redfish are swimming and waiting to be caught. For more information, go to ccastar.com.
Well, welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report. And I wish we could tell you where to go this weekend, but I just don't know. I know there's been a lot of good activity in the Atchafalaya Basin recently, and let's hope the storm doesn't take that away.
It's very hard to make a prediction and forecast a fishing report when you don't know what's going to come from which direction, how much salt water is going to be there, how much rainfall we're going to get. So, you know, all I can tell you is just, you know, kind of go back to what we did when we had prior hurricanes, and whatever worked for you then, give that a try.
Well, one of the things I'd like to tell everybody is, again, be patient. This weekend, we know it's a big holiday weekend coming. If the storm does do damage, think of the folks who have to get back there for their property and things like that. Let's don't push the button on fishing just yet. It might not be the time. We'll have plenty of time to catch the redfish and speckled trout, the bass and the sackalay later. You know, let those folks get their houses back in order, talking get their lives back in order.
And talking about fishing reports, the Saltwater Series had some pretty good winners this week.
Ryan Roussel and Landon Claus, 17.24 pounds, won it. That's two redfish measuring less than 27 inches long, $2,600, and that's pretty good. That's pretty good take home.
Yeah, you know, in the Saltwater Series, you're talking about that. You know, they got them coming up right now. They're going to be fishing tarpon, and then also, you know, just talk about saltwater fishing offshore was a good week. My brother and them made a trip last week with some clients, and they caught a lot of grouper and amberjack, and then made enough and made a trip. Was really good. Brought home some meat, and they was.
You know what I'd like to talk to you about too, the Pearl River. Where do you launch? Where's the best place to launch from there?
Well, you got Rigolet's Marina, which is a pretty close run there. There are several launches on the management area. If you want to come down the river, you can launch there. There's a big one right there on the East Pearl, probably the one with the best launch and a lot of parking.
That's Highway 90?
That's Highway 90, on Highway 90. But if you're going to fish that lower end and you got to get bait anyway, you know, you could launch at Dockside or Rigolet's Marina.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, George, I'm going to say the spillway. I'm going to say get there. You know, get there. But people catch a lot of bass. One day I want to have a discussion with y'all, too, about this 14-inch limit, because there's a lot of people right now with fishing tournaments right now and not catching enough keepers. They catch a lot of 13-inch fish down there. Been hearing a lot of complaints on that. I think they need to bring back some discussion on the 14-inch limit. But the sackalay, black and chartreuse, everywhere we went, a lot of people fishing black and chartreuse, fishing out in the grass. You know, the water's low in some areas. They're fishing out in the deep water body. When the sun comes up, they move up under the lilies.
Gary, we're fishing with a stationary carp about 18 inches under the water. We're using a black and chartreuse jig that has rings in it. And looks like they like that ring jig.
Oh, well, look,
coming through the bubbles.
That is exactly. It's amazing how they was on that grass.
Huh?
Amazing how he was on that grass. Go ahead, the bubbles come up. Hold him toward the camera. That's a good fish. Hold it toward the camera a little bit. There you go. There you go. You still got that black and short too. Come on. Hit him in. Goggle out.
If it ain't a cycle, it's a goggle eye, Gary.
A goggle eye? Another goggle eye? Yeah. Tinker Bear.
Shell Cracker, Chickapin.
Lake Runner.
Lake Runner.
All kind of names, huh? Spot. Oh, you got a little bass, huh?
Yeah,
that's
about the fourth one we done caught.
There you go.
That's a full back.
A little bass. Bring him toward the camera this way. There you go.
He like Bill Daniels, got a Troy back.
Yeah, that's a halfway decent one, Gary.
There you go,
buddy.
Put him toward the camera.
At least 3 pounder. Getting bigger. We're in a spillway. And in a couple of months, it's going to be even better.
Well, I'd just like to say this is my final show in Paradise, Louisiana. I'm going to miss you guys. Don, thank you for coming on. 10 years, babe. 10 years.
I ain't gonna let you get away that easy.
Well,
you know, but well, I know you got a new grandbaby. Congratulations on that little bull.
Yeah, Mr. Hank showed up 9 pounds last Friday, but I'd like to thank my family. 10 years, it's been pretty tough, and thank you for what you did. All right, here on Paradise, Louisiana, I'm gonna miss you folks a lot.
Thanks for the great job you did too. 10 years.
Thank you.
Joe, how are we going to get all these news? You know, I'm going to have to read the paper like I've been doing for 30 years.
That's it.
Get the news?
That's it.
Huh?
I guess.
Can I steal a few tidbits somewhere?
You can steal all you want. That's why it's out there. Yes, I'm going to miss you guys a lot. Thank you very much. And I don't know. Maybe I'll shed a tear today, too.
The feeling of future.
Paradise, Louisiana, powered by Chevrolet, would like to thank these sponsors. Aerial Access Equipment, the leader in aerial work platforms. Borden, if it's Borden, it's got to be good. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana. The Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores, we have more than you expect. Farm Bureau Insurance. Louisiana Fish Fry. Louisiana Land Bank. Mastercraft Tires. Area Wholesale Tires, with tire programs for tire dealers.